Welcome to this week's edition of FHS News. Tonight our 9-0 Jackets will be playing Harpeth. We need all the support we can get for those boys. The Crucible will be opening November 3rd, and we would appreciate it if you tried your best to come out. Also, be safe out there trick-or-treating. Now, let's check out another spooky news package.
Hello, I'm DJ Estes.
And I'm Tannis B.
And today, we're going to be doing dating and fashion tips.
We're going to be focused mainly on dating this week. And our theme is fall, and it's almost Halloween time, so we're going to be focused on Halloween and Halloween dates and just Halloween things in general. So, a couple things we can do. We're going to start off with dates, and we're going to do different Halloween date ideas. One Halloween date idea is haunted houses, you know, going with your girlfriend or your boyfriend. Just go with your boo and, you know, hold hands and be scared together. Really have a scary, fun experience together.
Do some do-it-yourself Halloween treats like cookies.
Rice Krispies.
Yeah, make some images out of it. Make a ghost, a pumpkin.
Ooh.
You could also do a jack-o'-lantern, maybe.
Ooh, that would be cool. Get some, like, orange that would, like, make it look like it's lit up.
That'd be
really cool.
Then you could also go trick-or-treating.
Ooh.
Go door-to-door, get some candy, get some Snickers.
Reese's. Some people.
Oh, yeah.
But you gotta make sure that you do some nice power couple costumes.
Mm-hmm.
So Peanut Butter and Jelly,
yes.
Mike Wazowski and Sully,
yes.
Drake and Rihanna.
Yes,
really.
Mustard and ketchup.
Ooh, a fire combination. Really just any costumes that would really fit for a couple.
But definitely do not dress as clowns.
No siree.
Woo!
We will kick you out of the neighborhood. No candy. We'll steal your candy bag and we'll eat it in front of your face.
Mmm. We're now gonna toss it to reviews.
Have a good week. All right.
Hello, Fairview High School. I'm Kelsey Sullivan.
And I'm Casey Sullivan.
And welcome to reviews.
Today we're gonna be reviewing the Halloween movie, The Nightmare Before Christmas.
That movie's about the Pumpkin King, Jack Skellington, who gets bored of scaring people for his town because they get ready to celebrate Halloween. And so they do this annual like routine where they just go and scare normal people, and he just kind of gets bored with it, so he goes and explores and finds Christmastown and wants to bring it back to his town and start something new.
because he sees like all the bright colors and like all the happy spirits, and he wants that. But this movie was originally made in 1993 by Tim Burton, and it's obviously a Halloween movie because like Tim Burton makes weird movies.
Yeah, it's kind of a weird movie. I wouldn't really recommend it for like young kids, just because it has like kidnapping Santa Claus and like popping heads off and just kind of creepy stuff like
that. It always scared me as a child.
Yeah, same.
My favorite part was always the part where like they did capture Santa Claus, because like he was always so happy and Jack was trying to, he didn't really know what he was doing, and it was just funny.
I always liked Jack, his like girlfriend, or like, yeah. I don't know her name, but I always liked her the most for some reason, because she always tried to like escape from that little dude, but like never really could. But yeah, it's a pretty decent movie. I'd recommend it if you're trying to get into the Halloween spirit.
Well, the website Rotten Tomatoes rated it a 94%, and that's a lot for Rotten Tomatoes. I give this movie a 9 stingers out of 10 because it's a very good movie.
Yeah, it gets you in the Halloween spirit.
So, all right. This has been Reviews with Casey.
And Kelsey.
Thanks for watching.
Thank you so much.
Hello and welcome to Fairview Sneakers, where we're going to be talking about sneaker reviews, sneaker shopping, sneaker collection, anything sneaker related, we got you, and it's all going to be in your local Fairview area. For today's episode, we are going to be reviewing a shoe, and it's the 2016 Nike Air Presto.
So here we have the Nike Air Presto GPX USA release. It's in a milky white, a blue, a lighter blue, and a red colorway. Right here you're going to see just the sole and how it's red and blue, and really just like the unique USA colorway, really good for patriotic style. Here you have a general release, just a denim Air Presto, but the something cool about it is that it has a gum sole, you can see right there, so it's really something different, and it goes with just about anything that you can wear. You have a navy blue, a cream gray, and then the denim blue with hints of brown and the gum sole. So this is the USA version of the Presto with shorts on. A couple cool things that you see about this Presto that isn't on the general release, you see the swirls that go throughout the upper part of it. You can actually see better on the heel tab, you can see, or just the heel in general, you can see the Nike Air, and that's something that's not very visible on the other one, even though it is there. If you look closely at the toe, you see the Nike symbol is red, and it has the swirls all throughout the upper, which isn't on the general release. And if you look on the tongue, you can see the USA print on it. Here you can see the general just with some denim. Nothing too special, same as the normal one, just denim. And here we have a side-by-side, seeing how related the shoes are, but in their own way, how they're different.
So after looking at the shoe, it looks great just about with everything you wear it with. It's really comfortable and it's a great looking shoe. You can wear it with just about anything depending on the colors. And overall, I'd have to give it a solid 9.5 out of 10. And there you have it, Fairview Sneakers, episode 1. We'll see you next week.
Hello everyone, I'm Luke Rains.
And I'm Zach Sidnor.
And today we are going to be discussing sports here in the Fairview football locker room.
So first off, a couple weeks ago, the Fairview Yellow Jackets played the East Hickman, and it was a very, very easy game.
Slobber knocker, I'd say.
We throttled them, as our coach, Coach Hughes, would say.
One of his favorite words to use when we destroy a team.
Yes. So we had one of our fellow cast members, Cade Rasmussen, score the opening touchdown for us. It was very good. Why don't you explain?
We had a play called Beast. It was a formation, and we had 11 of our biggest guys up blocking, and Cade was the one running the ball, and on his first play, he ran it right up the middle and dove. He was just short of the goal line. And then the next play, they ran a sweep, and Cade scored.
It was amazing. Everybody on the sideline was freaking out. And it was good. Good memory.
Also, we had a very special moment near the end of the game where we had our manager, Hunter Hammond, score the two-point conversion to put the game away. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that, Luke?
Well, that play was called Triple H, and basically they had 11 of the seniors out blocking for Hunter, and, 10 counting Hunter. And basically they just ran it straight up the middle, and Hunter plowed over guys, scored, and one of the best moments of my high school like experience and memories, just that'll always be something I'll never forget.
And last week, Fairview played Camden at Camden to help put us in position to win the region and also help us stay undefeated. And it was a very, very good game, very, very physical game for Fairview, as Fairview won 28-14. And why don't you tell us a little about that play from Josh Ortiz stripping the ball?
Well, Josh Ortiz, as soon as the ball was snapped, just came off and took the ball and ripped it out of this guy's hands, and he just took it and scored 6 points, and that really gave us the momentum and the edge over Camden. And after that, we ended it.
Just
our
put
defense
the game away.
Played a very physical game. Everything was fast, kind of like that was. Don't know what that was.
That was speed.
But yeah, it was a great game all around. I think we really played up to our ability, and I know the coaches were very happy with the way we played.
And this week, Fairview's playing Harpeth to keep, and if they win this game, they'll be 10-0, first time since
1979, 37 years.
And that would be very huge, and I believe they have some of the players from that team coming to the game,
don't they? There will be some players there.
It's a pink out game, we're gonna have a pep rally, but Luke, why don't you tell us a little bit about the pink out game?
Well, for the pink out, the Tennessee Titans get to select one team out of the Middle Tennessee area. Last year they chose Blackman High School, and this year they've selected Fairview. First off, we're 9-0. That led them to choosing us. And then Coach Hughes has connections with some of the people there. One named Josh Corey. He's the high school relations person for the Tennessee Titans. So they've actually got the players 60 tickets to their game against the Jacksonville Jaguars, which will be on Thursday, October 27th. And that's where we'll all be going. And basically the Titans, after their game, they're getting a big box of all their pink gear and they're shipping it to us. And we'll have it Friday for our game. Like, we'll have gloves and cleats and hand warmers and hats and towels, anything you could think of, we'll have it pink for our game on Friday against Harpeth.
Great.
Well, I'm Luke Rains.
I'm Zach Sidnor.
Have a safe, fun, happy Halloween.